Death Valley is the largest national park in the lower 48 states, more than three times the size of Rhode Island. Straddling the border of California and Nevada and surrounded by towering mountain peaks. 140 miles long and up to 15 miles wide, with temperatures reaching a scorching 134 degrees Fahrenheit. This is one of the most inhospitable places on Earth. But for geologists, Death Valley has a unique attraction. Here, they can witness the interplay of the Earth's most titanic geological forces.
When you look at Death Valley, really you're looking at a battle between processes that are occurring on the Earth's surface. And we can see the record of those forces of nature locked into the rocks. Death Valley has an archive that is almost unrivaled worldwide.
To uncover Death Valley's earliest history, Prave is hunting for its oldest rocks. He is searching in one of its most remote spots, in the extreme south of the valley, in the isolated Alexander Hills.
This is one of the oldest rocks in Death Valley. It's 1.2 billion years old. And given the color of this rock and the fact that it's quite soft, it can powder when I scratch it, these are all clues that tell me that this is a limestone.
The limestone is a major clue to revealing the way this arid desert used to look.
If we think about the type of environments that limestones can be deposited in, the first that comes to mind is an underwater in a marine setting.
There is only one way to form limestone. It is made from the tiny bones and shells of sea creatures. They die and sink to the sea floor, where the weight of further layers on top of them crushes them slowly into solid rock. And Prave has discovered other startling evidence that Death Valley had a watery past.
Fossils are a major clue. They are vital in the type of evidence that a geologist will use. And these are some very nice examples of the type of fossils that you can find in these ancient rocks. And you can see here these curving surfaces outlining what look to be large cabbages that are sliced in half. These were algae, known as a stromatolite.
Ironically, these marine fossils have survived in the Death Valley Desert only because there is so little water that might otherwise have washed them away. But they would have originally looked like this when they flourished in the Death Valley waters as the limestone formed more than 1 billion years ago.
These tell us that the environment, when this rock formed, would have been a shallow sea. If I'd been here when these rocks were first being formed, I'd be sitting in my swimming trunks about waist deep in water, very much like the Bahamas today.
The stromatolites are some of the earliest signs of life on our planet. To discover what happened over the next 1 billion years, Prave studies evidence in the surrounding hills.
The different bands of colors and the rock layers and the hills represent ancient seas that covered the Death Valley area. The seas would deposit a layer of limestone, move back across the land, another layer of limestone would be deposited. And so we have a history of the seas moving across the Death Valley region from the time of the stromatolites to these rock layers now, more than 1 billion years later.
Geologists wanted to figure out what dramatic geological upheaval could have turned Death Valley from a shallow sea to the baking hot desert of today. And Prave has found clues in a rock that is entirely different from the marine limestones he has studied up until now.
This is a nice example of a rock type called a granite. And it forms those veins that are in the hillside behind me. You can think of these like the fingers of my hand. They're fed upward from a much more larger, massive area of granite sitting underneath.
The granite tells scientists the reasons why Death Valley's ancient seas vanished. Today, it is solid rock. But it was once hot, molten magma from deep underground. Only one force of nature has the awesome power and 2,000 degree Fahrenheit heat to melt rock into magma and fire it to the surface. Volcanoes. The seas here didn't just drain away. They were pushed back by these mountains of fire. It was only in the 1960s, with the realization that Earth's continents were drifting around the planet, that scientists figured out why the volcanoes erupted under Death Valley. The theory of plate tectonics revealed that around 100 million years ago, an ancient oceanic plate began sinking under North America, pushing up the land. Heat from the collision powered a coastal chain of volcanoes, erupting on the land and finally driving away the seas, submerging Death Valley.
This landscape would have been very explosive, a hostile type of setting, and that then set the stage for what was to become Death Valley.
Still surviving in the valley to this day is the ghost town evidence of another substance, far rarer than granite, that the volcanoes brought to the surface. Gold. Although gold occurs naturally in more than 30 different U.S. states, the gold in Death